Hi everyone, I'm Claudia, international makeup artist. Welcome to my channel. Today I want to show you how to achieve this summer look. This is a glowy summer skin with a very simple eye and a glossy lip, just perfect for August. I'm going to start, of course, by making sure that the skin is very well cleansed, and I'm also balancing it out with the toner. This is the rose toner that I always use. And right now I want to apply a serum because it's a little bit more lightweight than a heavy cream, and I don't want a very heavy cream, especially because in the summertime it's very hot outside. So we don't want any heavy textures on our skin. For a spa moment, I'm using this Iconic London tool, which I also put in the fridge beforehand, so it's more relaxing and soothing for the skin. After that, I'm gonna also apply a little bit of a primer on the T-zone, a mattifying primer actually, because I want to make sure that the skin is not gonna look greasy right there, especially because it's gonna be, of course, very hot. It's August. I'm also moisturizing the lips very well. You know, I always do this step. It's very important because your lips are gonna look juicy and plumped. And guys, don't kill me, I don't know how I managed to do that, but apparently my camera didn't shoot the skin part, so where I applied the skin tint, I don't know what happened, the footage is just not there. I applied the Iconic London skin tint, which has a lovely, very sheer and glowy skin like texture, and it looks amazing, as you can already tell. And right now I'm blending in the concealer, which is a tiny bit lighter because I want to brighten up the skin a little bit. And as you can tell, I applied the darker shade on the face, but just to match it with her chest, because her chest was darker than her face, so this is why I used a darker shade on the face as well. Right now I'm using the cream bronzer, and actually the cream contour by Patrick Ta, and I'm applying it as usual on the temples, underneath the cheekbones, and on the hairline as well, because I want to add some dimension. But this looks so lightweight and just perfect for summer because it's not heavy at all, it just looks like skin. I'm using small brushes as usual because I want my work to be very well detailed, and I'm also applying the same contour on the nose for a little bit more dimension, and on the chin as well. Right now I'm moving on with the cream blush. I'm applying this beautiful pink shade more of the inside of the face, on the apples of the cheek, because you can go with the blush a little bit more inside than you went with the contour for that fresh, youthful summer skin look. And I'm blending it very well into the contour as well because I don't want to see any harsh lines at all. Next step is highlighter. I'm using the Liquid Illuminator by Iconic London as well, which has a lovely texture. It's amazing. You can mix it with your foundation, you can use it by its own, you can apply it on your eyes as well for that wet look effect. And after I apply it on the skin, it actually sets pretty well, so that's another plus for me. If you're watching my tutorials, you already know I love my nose highlight, so of course I'm applying a little bit of highlight on the nose as well, and I'm also applying it in the inner corners of the eyes for that bright and beautiful glow effect. And the next step is actually setting the face with a tiny bit of translucent powder, only on the center of the face, because I want to keep that youthful and fresh looking skin, but I don't want the greasy look on the T-zone. So this is why I'm using a translucent powder, especially around the nose area and underneath the eyes, because that's where the concealer usually starts to crease, because we have those little fine lines right there. For the eyes, I'm doing something super simple as usual. I'm just applying a brown shade all over the lid. This is a cream shadow. This is a Bobbi Brown stick actually, which is very easy to use and very easy to blend. I'm using this as my base and also to give a little bit of dimension to the eyes already. And after that, I'm gonna use a brown creamy pencil on the outer part of the eyes only. I wanna create a very thin and very soft brown flick, and this is why I'm also using the angled brush, in order to make sure that the edges are a little bit blended, and also make sure that the ending of the flick is very thin, which I can only achieve by using the brush, because the eyeliner itself is a little bit too thick for that. So this is why I'm using this angled brush as well. After that, I'm also gonna use the same pencil on the inner part of the eye. I'm making sure that I'm applying it on the waterline on the inside of the eye mostly, just because I want that definition right at the roots of the lashes. So this is why I'm making sure I'm going in there with the brown liner. I know it's a little bit tickly this step, but trust me, it's worth it. I just think this step is so satisfying. I'm now just using the Brow Freeze by Anastasia Beverly Hills, and I'm making sure that I'm brushing up the brows and giving them that laminated look. It looks so pretty, and she has amazing brows for that. And I'm also coming back with the brow pen because I also want to create some hair strokes, and especially because I want to define the brows a little bit on the areas where I feel like she misses a couple of hairs. So this is why I'm using right now the brow pen in the shade Taupe. And the most important thing while using this product is the position of your hand. This is how you are gonna be able to get the hair strokes the natural way, the most natural way possible. I feel like a lot of you have issues with that, so just practice with the position of your hand so that you can create those flawless head strokes. For the lips, I'm now using one of my favorites, the KKW Beauty 1.5 Nude. I just love this pencil. You already know, you see it so often in my tutorials, and it's for a reason. It's because it has such an amazing formula. I'm just lining the lips and flinging the edges just a little bit, and after that I'm using this beautiful gloss all over the lips, which is a peachy shade, which just screams summer to me. So this whole look looks just so luminous, glowy and delicious. After you apply your lip gloss, you can also spray some setting spray on the face just to make sure that everything will stay in place for the whole day. And this is the finished look. Of course, take some selfies, enjoy the makeup, and don't forget to post it on your Instagram if you recreated, and tag me in your story so that I can see your beautiful recreations. Thank you so much for watching.